But I pray, God, make us so sensitive. I just don't want to go through the motions, but I've got to have the power of the Holy Ghost. I want God in full control of every service, every life. I want to come into His house with thanksgiving and with praise.
You see, long before the prodigal ever left, long before he ever packed his bags, long before he ever said, "Father, give me my portion," long before he ever walked out the door.
Oh, you're right.
Brother Carter, there was something that had already made the journey.
Oh, you're right.
There was something that had already been to the far country. Young person, I know there are not rank backsliders sitting on these first few rows here tonight.
Come on.
You don't get this preacher wrong. But I know the devil has been hounding some of your hearts and trying to get your focus on the far country rather than home. The battleground is in the heart. But if your heart is right with God, you can serve God anywhere. If your heart is steadfastly set upon God, regardless of who backslides, regardless of who encourages you and discourages you, you can walk with God because your heart is set on God.
Is fixed on thee, oh God. But you don't have to be the next one to leave the Father's house. Some of you have been raised in this house. My friend, stay in the house.
Stay in the house.
Yes, the prodigal left the father. I know his brother had a bad attitude. Say what you will about his brother. His brother stayed home.
Stayed home.
Amen.
Stayed in the house.
You didn't hear me right there.
Yeah.
Say what you will. At least his brother stayed in the house. The prodigal had scars, but his brother didn't have those wounds. The prodigal lost it all, but his brother still lived in the blessing. You don't have to backslide.
Said this, the prodigal may return, but he will come back worse than he went away.
Yes.
He may return, but he will be covered with the scars and the shame of sin. He may repent, but he cannot undo the past. He may come with bitter tears, but the guilt clings to him wherever he goes. He may be forgiven. He may be restored to a son's place, but he can never be as if he had never gone out. Forgiveness does not take away the scars that sin makes. Young person, stay in the house. Young lady, stay in the house. Sinner before you can be used of God. You don't have to become lost.
Right.
You see, I'll get excited, Brother Justin, over the testimony of how God saves from drugs, how God saves from alcohol, how God saves from low living. I'll get behind you. Glory to God. I'm thankful for the mercy of God. I'll get right behind you, Brother Carter. We'll get right in there with him.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah.
But you want to see me shout? You want to see me dance? You want to see me just about lose my shoes? It's when one of these young folks can stand. I never tasted alcohol. Never smoked a cigarette. Never been to the ballroom. Never dressed like the world. Never went out and had an affair with the world. Oh, but I stayed in the house. I let God use me. I let God get all over me. Young people, stay in the house. Get in the full control of God. The far country will cause you scars, but the Father's house, there is rejoicing. The far country is dark, but in the Father's house, you're living in the light. The far country, there is wickedness all around, but in the Father's house, there's the holy Word of God. The far country, there is sin, but in the Father's house, there is singing, there is worshiping, there is rejoicing. The far country will bring you pain, but in the Father's house, you're in the presence of the Father. Oh, stay in the house. I said, stay in the house. You don't have to be the next runaway, but stay in the house. Need some runaways in this house.
Oh, oh. Yeah.
So I'd like to see some runaways right now.
Come on.
I'd like to see some of these young folks run away. I'd like to see them run away from sin.
Yes.
Flee youthful lust. I'd like to see them run away from the world. I'd like to see them run away from wickedness. I'd like to see him run away from worldliness. I'd like to see him run away from those dead, dry services. I'd like to see him get so on fire for God that they just run as fast as they can away from this world, away from the far country, and whatever the devil has, get closer, run away, run back to the house. We need some runaways.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
God told the Israelites, you place the blood upon the doorpost. You close the door and you stay in the house. That's what God is saying tonight.
Yeah.
Right.
You get under that blood. Young person.
Get under the blood.
Visitor.
Yeah.
You get under that blood and you stay in the house.
Stay
in
the house.
What have you replaced the Word of God with? Words of friends? Words of a seared conscience? What have you replaced the Spirit of God with? Moments of carnality? The trinkets and the gadgets of this world? What have you replaced the touch of God with? What have you replaced the blessings of God with? Oh, there is nothing that can take the place of joy unspeakable. I come to preach to you tonight by the Spirit of God that there are some amongst us right now. I have read your heart in prayer, and backsliding in the far country is in your heart. Your heart is beating in another direction. Your thoughts are far from God. Your thoughts are taking you out of the house of God. It's harder to pray. It's been harder to shout. It's becoming harder to have church. It's becoming harder to sing. Harder to stand. Because you just don't care about it anymore. Some of you in the last few days have made this statement. Well, for the Holy Ghost. You said, if I quit, no one will even notice anyway. Oh, we'll notice, young person. But more importantly, God will notice.
Yes, He will.
Don't be a runaway. Now's your chance to get back home. I feel it all over me. Now's your chance to turn your back on the far country, to leave the homes, to leave the home pen, to leave them friends, to leave them little addictions, to leave whatever has you bound. Doth he not leave the 99 going to the mountains and seek it, that which is gone astray?
Oh, yes.
There was a newspaper reporter that went to live with a sheep herder in Scotland many years ago. He lived there for 6 months writing an article. One night while they were sitting on the porch, they were talking about the sheep. That sheep herder, that shepherd, talked very highly of his sheep. The next morning, to their dismay, the sheep herder said, "One of my little lambs has getting gotten out. I don't know where he's went. He's ran away." That newspaper reporter said, "What are you going to do? What's he going to go find him?" That sheep herder said, "You'll see. I just wait till almost dark."
Oh, God.
Evening fell, Brother Wetzel. And that newspaper reporter watched as that shepherd began to walk through them hills. He began to yell out a phrase in another language. The newspaper reporter didn't know what he was saying. Pretty soon, as he is yelling that phrase, they begin to hear the bleating of a little lamb.
Yes.
It wasn't long, Brother Bird, until that little lamb began to run toward the shepherd. They got back to the house. Brother Larry and newspaper reporter said, "What was you saying?" The shepherd says, "When I have sheep that goes astray, I always wait right till dark For that little man will begin to worry. And little man will begin to get scared. And I'll begin to cry out to him. But what did you say? The shepherd says, all I say is come home.
Yes. Yes.
Come home. Young people, tonight, the shepherd of your soul. Jesus Christ is walking in his eyes. Listen real close, and you'll begin to hear him call.
Come home. Come home. Come home.
Come home.
Can you hear him?
Come home.
Step out. Which young man's gonna stop?